guys, welcome to Learning Mathematics with Prep Class. I am BC, I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, we are going to be solving Loyola Jesuit College Entrance Examination Mathematics Paper 3 from question 41 to question 45. Subscribe to our channel. This is where you can get more videos like this, where you will learn how to choose the correct answers to your questions and how to pass very well in your examination. Also, don't forget to like and comment on this video, as I'll be happy to respond to your comments in the comment section. So, let's move on to the first question in this video, question 41. 27 whole number 3 over 4 minus 14 whole number 5 over 6. So, you can see that these are fractions. So many students think that fractions are very difficult. Oh, it's too difficult, it's too difficult. No, it's not. Fractions are actually very easy. So follow me while I teach you how to solve this question on fractions. Okay, so first of all, what kind of fractions are these? Can you see that there is a whole number part and a fraction part? 27 whole number 3 over 4 minus 14 whole number 5 over 6. So these are mixed fractions. They are mixed fractions because they have the whole number part and the fraction part. Now, what we have to do first is to convert the mixed fractions to improper fractions. And this is done by whole number multiplied by denominator plus numerator all divided by the denominator. So let's do that here. This is the whole number, this is the denominator, this is the numerator. So 27 multiplied by 4 plus 3 divided by 4. That would give us 111 over 4. Then 14 whole number 5 over 6 can be converted to mixed fraction by multiplying 14 and 6 plus 5 divided by 6, which is the denominator. And this will give us 89 over 6. So now 27 whole number 3 over 4 minus 14 whole number 5 over 6 is now 111 over 4 minus 89 over 6. Now, can you see that these are unlike fractions? That is, they do not have the same denominator. So the first thing is to find a common denominator. Before we can subtract this fraction, we need to find a common denominator. And this can be done by obtaining the LCM of the denominators 4 and 6. LCM is lowest common multiple. So using prime factorization method, let's express each of the denominators as a product of its prime factors. So prime factors are the prime numbers that you multiply together to get a number. So 4 is 2 times 2. 6 is 2 times 3. So 2 times 2 will give us 4. So 2 and 2 are the prime factors of 4. 2 times 3 will give us 6, so 2 and 3 are the prime factors of 6. Now, the next thing is to multiply the prime factors. When you have any common factor, write it just once. So now we have 2 times 2 times 3, which is 12. So 12 is the LCM of 4 and 6. Now that we have obtained the LCM, we have to convert the denominator of each fraction to the LCM. Remember, what we are trying to do is to convert them to like fractions. Okay, so the first fraction is 111 divided by 4. So 4 times 1 number will give us 12. 4 times 3 is 12. Then we do the same to the numerator as well. 113 times 3 is 333. The second fraction is 89 over 6. 6 multiplied by 1 number will give us 12. 6 multiplied by 2 will give 12. Then 89 multiplied by 2 as well. We must also multiply the numerator by the number, by the same number, okay? So 89 multiplied by 2 is 178. Now, the next thing, now we have 111 over 4 minus 89 over 6 equals 333 over 12 minus 178 over 12. Can you see now that they are like fractions? They are the same denominator. Wow! Yes, we've done it. Okay, now that we have converted to like fractions, all we have to do is to subtract the numerators and divide by the common denominator. So here we have 333 minus 178 divided by 12. 333 minus 178 is 155 divided by the common denominator, which is 12. So now 111 minus 4 minus 89 over 6 is now 155 over 12. So this is correct. We have gotten our answer, but we are not sure. Why? Because all the options are mixed fractions. So this means that we have to convert this fraction to a mixed fraction. Okay, so let's do that here. How do we convert to mixed fractions? This is done by dividing the numerator by the denominator, then write as quotient. The quotient is the whole number, then remainder over denominator. That's the fraction. Okay, so let's do that here. 155 divided by 12. 15 divided by 12 is 1. 1 times 12 is 12. 15 minus 12 is 3. Then drop down the next digit, which is 5. 35 divided by 12 is 2. 2 times 12 is 24. 34 divided by 24 is 11. So the quotient is 12, and then the remainder is 11. So 155 divided by 12 is 12 whole number, 11 over 12. Can you see that fractions are not so difficult after all? Alright, so which of the options is correct? The correct option is D, 12 whole number, 11 over 12. Now, let's move on to the next question, question 42. Evaluate 75 squared. So, this is actually very, very easy. All we have to do is to find the square of 75. So, what is the square of a number? The square of a number is the value obtained when the number is multiplied by itself. So, 75 squared is 75 times 75. So, 75 squared is 75 times 75. Let's do that here. 5 times 5 is 25. Write 5, carry 2. 5 times 7 is 35. 35 plus 2 is 37. 7 times 5 is 35. Write 5, carry 3. 7 times 7 is 49. Plus 3, that is 52. So let's add this together now. 5 plus nothing is 5. 7 plus 5 is 12. Write 2, carry 1. 1 plus 3 is 4. 4 plus 2 is 6. Then 5 plus nothing is 5. So 75 squared is 5,625. So, we have done that. All you have to do is to just multiply the number by itself and then you get your answer. So, which of the options is correct? The correct option is A, 5,625. So, question 43 says, a trader bought an item for 4,138 naira. He then sold it at a profit of 19,076 naira, 18 kobo. What is his percentage profit? Wow, this is interesting. So let's bring out the information in this question. A trader bought an item for 4,138 naira. So this means that the cost price is 4,138 naira. The cost price is the amount an item was bought. Then he then sold it at a profit of 19,076 naira, 18 kobo. So this is the profit that he made. Then what is his percentage profit? So, percentage profit is calculated by the formula profit over cost price multiplied by 100. So, the profit is 19,076 naira, 18 kobo, divided by the cost price, which is 4,138 naira, multiplied by 100. 19,076 naira, 18 kobo, multiplied by 100 is 1,907,618 naira. Divided by 4,138 naira. Naira cancels naira. So we have 1,907,618 divided by 4,138. So let's do that here using the long division method. So we have to find the first possible digit that is divisible by 4,138. So the first possible digit is 19,076. 19,076 divided by 4,138 is 4. 4 times 4,138 is 16,552. Now let's subtract 16,552 from 19,076. 6 minus 2 is 4. 7 minus 5 is 2. 0 minus 5 is not possible. So we have to get 1 from 9 and then this becomes 8. And we put the 1 here, this becomes 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. Okay, so it's remaining 8 now. 8 minus 6 is 2. 1 minus 1 is 0, so we do not write it. So now we have 2,524, which is not divisible by 4,138. So we have to bring down the next digit, which is 1. So we now have 25,241 divided by 4,138, which would give us 6. 6 multiplied by 4,138 is 24,828. Now let's subtract 24,828 from 25,241. 1 minus 8 is not possible, so we get 1 from 4. This remains 3, and we put the 1 here. This is 11. 11 minus 8 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. 2 minus 8 is not possible, so we get 1 from 5. The it remains 4, and we put the 1 here, this becomes 12. 12 minus 8 is 4, 4 minus 4 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, so we don't write it. So now we have 413, which is not divisible by 4138. So we have to bring down the next digit, which is 8. So this is now 4138 divided by 4138, which will give us 1. 4138 minus 4138 is 0. So now we've been able to completely divide 1,907,618 by 4138. So the answer is 461%. So the percentage profit of this trader is 461%. So you can see that that is very easy. So which of these options is correct? The correct option is D, 461.0. That is the trader's percentage profit. Question 44. Find the perimeter of the rectangle shown. So this is the rectangle. The length here is 72 centimeters and the breadth is 57 centimeters. So what is the formula for finding the perimeter of the rectangle? Or first of all, what is even a perimeter? A perimeter is the distance around a shape. Perimeter is the distance around a shape. The perimeter of a rectangle is found using the formula 2 length plus breadth. The length here is 72 centimeters and the breadth is 57 centimeters. So let's do that here. Perimeter of rectangle equals 2 times 72 centimeters plus 57 centimeters. That's the length and the breadth. Now, the first thing is to do the operation in bracket, which is 72 centimeters plus 57 centimeters. We can do that here. 2 plus 7 is 9, 7 plus 5 is 12. So 72 centimeters plus 57 centimeters is 129 centimeters. So this means 2 multiplied by 129 centimeters, which we can do here. 2 times 9 is 18, write 8, carry 1. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1, 5. 2 times 1 is 2. So that is 258. So the perimeter of this rectangle is 258 centimeters. So all you have to do is to make use of the formula 2L plus breadth, and then you will get your answer. So which of the options is correct? Option C is the correct option, 258 centimeters. Now the last question in this video, question 45. 66.89 multiplied by 4.84 equals, so these are decimal numbers. What are decimal numbers? Decimal numbers are numbers that have a decimal point. Okay, so how do we multiply decimal numbers? What you have to do is to remove the decimal point. So multiply the decimal numbers as usual, the way you do the usual multiplication. So remove the decimal point. So now we now have 6689 and 484. So let's multiply this now. 4 times 9 is 36, write 6, carry 3. 4 times 8 is 32. 32 plus 3 is 35, write 5, carry 3. 4 times 6 is 24, 24 plus 3 is 27, write 7, carry 2. 4 times 6 is 24, 24 plus 2 is 26. Now, 8 multiplied by 9 is 72, write 2, carry 7. 8 times 8 is 64, 64 plus 7 is 71, so write 1, carry 7. 8 times 6 is 48. 48 plus 7 is 55. So write 5, carry 5. 8 times 6 is 48. 48 plus 5 is 53. So write it here, 53. Now, 4 times 9 is 36. Write 6, carry 3. 4 times 8 is 32. 32 plus 3 is 35. So write 5, carry 3. 4 times 6 is 24. 24 plus 3 is 27. Write 7, carry 2. 4 times 6 is 24, 24 plus 22, 24 plus 2 is 26. Now let's add these numbers together. 6 plus nothing is 6, 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 plus 6 is 14, write 4, carry 1. 1 plus 6 is 7, 7 plus 5 is 12, 12 plus 5 is 17, write 7, carry 1. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 7 is 13, write 3, carry 1. 1 plus 5 is 6, 6 plus 6 is 12. Write 2, carry 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. So now the answer is 3,237,476. But remember that these are decimals, right? So we remove the decimal points in order to multiply them. So the next thing is to check how many decimal places the decimal numbers are. So 66.81 has two decimal places. How do you know the number of decimal places? So the number of decimal places is the number of digits after the decimal point, or the number of digits in the decimal part. So this has two numbers after the decimal point. So this is two decimal places. 4.84 has two numbers after the decimal point. So it has two decimal places. So for us to be able to now find out how many decimal places the product will have, just find the sum of the decimal places in the two decimal numbers. So 2 plus 2 is 4. So in total, there are 4 decimal places. So we're going to put 4 decimal places in the product. So let's do that. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we put the decimal point here. So now the answer is 323.7476. So you can see that this is actually very easy. So multiply without the decimal point. Then after that, find the sum of the decimal places in decimal numbers to get the number of decimal places in the product. That's all. So the correct option here is A, 323.7476. I hope you enjoyed this video and you're able to learn a lot from it. Kindly subscribe to our channel, like and comment on our videos. You can also join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Till I come your way next time, bye for now.